बेसिक्स ऑफ अल्को एंड एचएचपी लोको टेक्नोलॉजी एंड शेड्यूल मेंटेनेंस। दिस टॉपिक इज स्पेशली डिजाइन फॉर दोज रेलवेज प्रोविजनर्स हु आर नॉट फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग बैकग्राउंड बट वांट टू नो द बेसिक इंजीनियरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ डीजल इलेक्ट्रिकल लोकोमोटिव ऑफ इंडियन रेलवे। दिस टॉपिक may also be equally useful for IRSME provisioner. Objectives. After completions of these sessions, viewers may know that when diesel electrical locomotive came in Indian Railways and presently how many diesel locomotives are in service. The viewer may also understand the basics engineering configurations of diesel loco. Further, the viewer may also conclude the importance of diesel loco in Indian Railways. The types of scheduled maintenance on locomotives can also be known in this session. So let's move. Introduction of diesel traction. In year 1957 around, first diesel locomotive, that is WDM1, of Alco design was introduced in main line of Indian Railway. After that, Indian Railway had started thinking for conversion of main line from steam traction to diesel traction. So Indian Railway has made TOT with American Locomotive Company USA and introduced first homemade Alco design WDM2 diesel locomotive in 1962. It was manufactured at DLW Varanasi. After that, gradually modification and improvement made in WDM2 loco to upgrade its horsepower up to 3300 HP. Another era of diesel loco started in 1999 when GM loco, that is WDG4 and WDP4 of 4000 HP introduced in Indian Railway under TOT. Its manufacturing also started in 2001 at DLW Varanasi. Further modifications made in this loco to achieve better horsepower up to 4500 horsepower. Now these upgraded diesel locomotive are known as HHP or high horsepower loco. Benefits and drawback of diesel loco. First, we will discuss on benefits. When our country is involved in world war or war with the neighbors, that time diesel locomotive play a vital role in supply of foods, manpower and other needy items to the affected areas where electrical power supply is breakdown. In view of safety, diesel locomotive may be a suitable source for hauling of mineral raw materials from the mines area. When power grids fail, that time movements of train stops and railway line gets blocked. This time diesel locomotive play vital role and helps in running the train to its destination. Diesel locomotive is more reliable in natural disaster also. These locomotives having some drawback, like it directly pollutes atmospheric air. Another drawback is it having low reliability. Diesel loco in service over Indian Railways. As of April 2020, Indian Railways having 12,400 electric as well as diesel locomotive in service on main line. Out of 12,400 locomotives, 5,589 locos are diesel locomotive, which is approximately 45% of total loco holding. In this slide, the strength of various diesel locomotive can be easily understood. Basic technologies in diesel loco. There are currently three types of diesel locomotives being used over Indian Railways. The locomotive of Alco type is having four-stroke engine technology, while GM or EMD type's locomotive is having two-stroke engine technology. Recently, General Electrical Company or GE has introduced new locomotive which has four-stroke engine technology. Alco Loco and types. Now let us discuss on Alco Loco separately. The first homemade diesel locomotives introduced in Indian Railway was WDM-2 of 2600 horsepower. This locomotive was of Alco design and it was suitable for passenger as well as goods. Further, it had been upgraded to 3100 HP along with the improvement in fuel economy to 8% and lube oil consumption reduction to 2.5%. Again, the technological improvements were made to uprate the engine to 3300 HP and the name of loco is given as WDM-3D. Some Alco designs loco were also used for goods operation and passenger operations separately. Parameters of Alco Loco. This slide reflects the basic important parameters of various type of Alco designs locomotives serving over Indian Railways. The important locomotives are WDM-2, WDM-3A, WDM-3D, WDP-1, WDP-3A, WDG-3A. WDG-3A is most successful locomotives, especially for the goods operation. Special features of Alco Loco, that is WDG-3A. This locomotive is one of the most successful locomotive of Alco design. This locomotives was developed in response to problems noted with the WDM-2, such as ride quality, lateral oscillation, and poor traction with heavy load. These were initially classified as WDG-2C, but later on changed to WDG-3A in line with the new classification scheme issued by Railway Board wide letter number 2000/M in bracket L/466/44/8 in bracket NC bracket close dated 14/3/2002. Schedule maintenance of Alco Loco. Schedule maintenance is carried out to get better output from locomotive as per hauling requirement. It is carried out as per instruction issued by RDSO wide MP-miscellaneous.141 revised 1. The maintenance schedule is broadly classified into three categories. These are minor schedule, medium schedule, and major schedule. Quarterly and half-yearly schedules are classified into medium schedule, while yearly, three-yearly and POH are classified into major schedule. GM Loco and types. In 1999, Indian Railways introduced its first diesel-electric locomotive with three-phase AC traction technology, that is WDG-4 and WDP-4. This technology taken from General Motor USA under TOT. WDG-4 is suitable for goods operation while WDP-4 is suitable for passenger operation. Further, freight loco, that is WDG-4, is uprated to WDG-4D of 4500 HP. Similarly, passenger loco WDP-4 is also uprated to WDP-4D of 4500 HP. 4D and WDG-4D. In this slide, what are the differences between WDG4 and WDP4, that will be covered. Both locomotives are of GM design and both having the same horsepower, that is 4000 HP. WDP4 locomotive is suitable for the passenger operations, while WG4 is suitable for the freight operation. WDP4 locomotives can run with 160 km per hour. It is the operating speed. And WDG4 can run suitably with 100 km per hour. The axle load in case of WDP4 is 19.5 ton, while axle load of WDG4 is 21 ton. Tractive effort of WDP4 locomotive is 27.5 ton, while the tractive effort of WDG4 is 53 ton, which is very high. The bogie configurations of WDP4 is BO1-1BO, means in WDP4 there are 4 traction motor total. WDG4 having coco bogie configuration. The gear ratio of WDP4 is 77:17, while in case of WDG4, the gear ratio is 90:17. Parameters of GM locos. GM locomotive was provided with V-type diesel engine, which is 16 cylinders, 2-stroke engine, capable of developing 4000 HP. Engine is equipped with a high efficiency turbo supercharger for better fuel efficiency. Control of the entire locomotive is done through a microprocessor system with EM2000 computer. While this locomotive introduced, its fuel efficiency was around 11% better than that existing locomotives. Other parameters of various type GM loco may be seen in this slide. GM / EMD layout. The GM / EMD locomotives can be broadly divided into 10 compartments where various parts are located. These compartments are: first, nose compartment or air brake rack. Second, driver cabin. Third, electrical control cabinet or high voltage cabinet, that is HVC. Fourth, traction control converter compartment or TCC. Fifth, centralized air compartment. Sixth, traction generator compartment. Seventh, engine compartment. Eighth, engine accessories compartment. Ninth, compressor compartment. And 10th, radiator compartment. Front view of locomotive. In this slide, major electrical and mechanical components involved in GM locos are indicated here. The end of locomotives near to driver cabin number 1 is called as short hood end, and the other end of the locomotive is called as long hood end. When driver is sitting in driver cabin number 1 and facing toward short hood directions, the left side of driver is called as left side of locomotive, and right hand side of driver is called as right side of locomotive. Left side and right side of main diesel engine will be just vice versa of locomotive sides. The major components involved in this locomotives are diesel engine, traction generator, turbo supercharger, one main generator blower, traction motor blower. There are six traction motor also, one air compressor, two radiator fans, one expansion tank, and one Luwile cooler, two sets of radiator core, and two numbers of grid cooling fan, etc. Locomotive operation of WDG4. In this slide, loco operation system is discussed briefly as: initially, two starting motors mounted at the rear right hand side of the engine do the cranking of diesel engine. When the engine is started and got rated RPM, the traction alternator, which is connected to the main engine crankshaft, generates power and supplies high voltage electrical energy to the electrical control cabinet. This cabinet controls power distribution. Further, control power converted into AC power with the help of traction control converter, that is TCC, and goes to traction motor mounted on wheel axle. At the end, traction motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy and further to kinetic energy in form of rolling of wheels over rail track. Main engine. Main engine is a vital mechanical assembly which consists of mainly crankshaft, crankcase assembly, power assembly, exhaust manifold, etc. The main function of main engine is to convert the chemical energy into mechanical energy by burning of diesel fuel inside 16 closed chambers by compression ignition process. Main alternator or traction alternator. Main alternator is a 3-phase 10 pole 90 slots machine equipped with two independent sets of stator winding. The main alternator converts the mechanical power of diesel engine into alternating current. The internal rectifier bank of the main alternator converts alternating current into direct current, thereby providing a DC power output. Other details may be read in this slide. Companion alternator. Companion alternator is a 3-phase AC steady state alternator of 250 kVA rating, which is physically connected but electrically independent of the main alternator. The companion alternator rotor field is excited directly by auxiliary supply of the locomotive. The companion alternator develops power whenever the diesel engine is running. It is used for excitations of the main alternator as well as for supply to dustbin blower, TCC blower, and radiator fan. Other details may be read in this slide. Auxiliary generator is driven by right side camshaft of main engine at 3 times of engine speed. It supplies AC power to rectifier in the battery charging system. Then it is converted into 74 volt DC for companion alternator, excitation control system, and locomotive battery charging. It also supplies DC power to fuel pump motor, turbo supercharger Luwile pump motor, battery charging locomotive, lighting, etc. it's having rectified output rating 18 kilowatt. Engine starting motor. Engine starting motor gets power from loco battery set and do the cranking of main engine of GM locomotive. Once main engine is started and got rated RPM, it get disengaged. GM oblique HHP turbo supercharger. Turbo supercharger is a pressure boosting device used to increase inlet air density by supplying air at pressure higher than the pressure at which engine naturally aspirates by utilizing the exhaust energy of the engine with help of gas turbine. Turbo supercharger basically consists of a compressor and a turbine coupled on a common shaft. HHP turbo supercharger has single stage centrifugal compressor and single stage axle flow type turbine. GM or HHP turbo supercharger is initially driven by engine by means of gear and clutch arrangement, and after a certain RPM of turbo rotor, that is 12,000 RPM, it change over to exhaust gases. That's why the turbo supercharger of HHP is also called as dual behavior turbo supercharger. GM or HHP engine accessories. In GM locomotive, there are so many engine accessories items like Woodward governor, Louvel pumps, water pumps, Louvel cooler, pressurized water tank, it is also called as expansion tank, fuel primary filters, fuel pump with motors, and engine protection device or EPD. These all items usually forms in accessories compartment. Engine protection device. In GM locomotive, mainly there are four engine safety devices. These devices or sensors inputs are designed to shut down the engines in the event of a malfunctioning occurring during engine operations. These safety devices are low oil pressure shutdown plunger, which is fitted in the governor. Second, low water and crankcase pressure detector assembly. Third, over speed trip or mechanical over speed trip. Fourth, hot oil detector. HHP air compressor. In GM locomotive, air compressor is driven by main engine crankshaft. It compresses air especially for brake operation. It is two stage, three cylinders, water-cooled air compressor. Its working pressure is 9.84 kgf per centimeter square. Radiator core and radiator fan. In HHP or GM locomotive, the radiator core and radiator fan are located in radiator compartment. Radiator core is roof mounted and the water circulating in its tube is cooled by two radiator cooling fan. Radiator cooling fans are driven by AC motors which gets power from companion alternator. Superstructure of HHP loco. Superstructure is also called as underframe of diesel locomotive. It has been designed on the platform concept on which the layout and the mounting of equipments arranged. Fuel tank, main reservoir, air dryer, sandboxes and various cutoff cocks are attached with this superstructure. Traction motor. Traction motor is a four-pole, three-phase induction motors designed to deliver very high torques required for the high starting tractive effort of the locomotive. The motor is of a extreme robust design suitable for challenging operations conditions, example highly dust environment and vibrations experienced on the tracks. In braking modes, three phase motors act as generators and power is fed back to the DC link via the loco, the two inverters. Other technical parameter may be read in this slide. HHP bogies. The GM locomotive is equipped with a high addition HTSC, means high tensile steel cast truck or bogy. The bogies assembly supports the weight of the locomotives and provides the means for transmission of power to the rails. The HTSC bogy is designed as a powered bolsterless unit. Other details related to bogies may be read in this slide. HHP/GM maintenance schedule. Schedule maintenance of locomotive is usually carried out to get the better performance from the locomotive and to get the better reliabilities. In GM locomotive, the POH schedule is carried out after 18 years, which is too long. Apart from this, IOH schedule is carried out after 12 years. Another schedules are also there, that is 3-yearly schedule, 1-yearly schedule, 90-day schedules, and 30-day schedule. These all schedule maintenance are carried out as per RDSO instructions and guideline. Manufacturing and future plan related to diesel locomotive. Under Railway Board's instructions, DLW means Diesel Locomotives Works has almost stopped manufacturing of diesel locomotives and started manufacturing of electrical locomotives. As per production plan, in 2019 and 20, only 6 diesel locomotive of WDP4D type are manufactured and more than 300 electrical locomotives are manufactured. DLW Varanasi has started conversions of diesel locomotive into electrical locomotive also. First loco was dispatched on 28 February 2018. The name of this locomotive is given as WAG11. This converted loco having 11,000 HP. It is combinations of two sections. It is capable for hauling 5,200 tons load at maximum permissible speed of 75 km per hour. In 2019 and 20, DLW has produced one dual mode locomotive also. This locomotive is a combination of diesel locomotive and electrical locomotive. In this locomotive, there is a diesel engine of 4500 HP, and in case of overhead power supply, this locomotives may work as a electrical locomotive with 6000 HP. The name of this locomotive is given as WDAP5 and dispatched in March 2019. Introduction of G locomotives. As I discussed in previous slide, that new diesel electrical locomotive manufactured by G or General Electrical USA is also introduced in Indian Railways in October 2017. These days, as of April 2020, around 183 locos of WDG4G type of 4500 horsepower are running on Indian Railways track. This locomotive is being manufactured at Diesel Locomotive Factory Marhora in Bihar, which is a joint venture between Indian Railways and General Electric USA. The plant will produce 100 locomotives per year for 10 years. General Electric would maintain the locomotive until the 13th year of the contract, at which point Indian Railways would take over responsibility of maintenance. Special feature of WDG4G locomotive. These locomotives having 4,500 horsepower. Its bogie arrangement is coco, and in this locomotive there are two driver cab. This locomotive's engine is four-stroke and V-type. It is fully turbocharged intercooled locomotive. It has AC-AC transmission system. Its tractive effort is 544 kN. In this locomotive, electronics brake system is provided and it is suitable for 100 km per hour. Other technical parameters are given in this slide, which can be read. WDG6G locomotive. WDG6G loco is also manufactured by GE and its horsepower is 6000 HP. Under PPP, GE will manufacture 300 WDG6G locomotive for Indian Railway in 10 years. Presently, as of April 2020, around 7 WDG6G locomotives are manufactured by GE and its oscillations trial is under progress. In this slide, GM locomotive is compared with the GE, which can be read and easily understand. Thank you very much to all of you. Have a nice day.